गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी हैव अनदर लेक्चर ऑफ थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन एंड टुडेज टॉपिक व्हिच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज डिस्क ब्रेक। सो आई हैव डायग्राम ड्रॉन अ डायग्राम ऑफ अ सेक्शनल व्यू ऑफ अ डिस्क ब्रेक। सो दीज आर द फ्यू अरेंजमेंट्स। दिस इज द पाइप और कनेक्टिंग ट्यूब थ्रू विच द हाइड्रोलिक फ्लूइड फ्रॉम द मास्टर सिलेंडर टू द पिस्टन विल ट्रेवल एंड दिज two portions are the two pistons, I will mention that also. These are the two friction pads. This is ultimately the cylinder and this one is the brake disc. So how disc brake works? Simply, in simple words, if I can say that how disc brake works, so all we know that disc brake is being functioned by the help of an hydraulic fluid. That means a hydraulic fluid is being traveled through a passage to the cylindrical piston area, and through that pressure of that fluid, the piston is moved inward and it ultimately attached to the disc, and which ultimately connected with the wheel, which helps the to apply the braking action, and through that the ultimately brake is being applied. So in simple word, we can say that the frictional resistance or the frictional force in case of disc brake is being formed by the help of hydraulic fluid. That means hydraulic fluid is the main cause enhancement or the main purpose of disc brake, which ultimately helps the disc brake to be so much sensitive and so much appropriate or much accurate or less time taking brake. So I have written the few statement how the mechanism or the disc brake, how it works. So the disc brake has a metal disc, as you will know that we have a metal disc and a pair of flat brake pads instead of drum and curb brake shoes. In previous cases, as in case of shoe brake, band brake, internal expanding brake, we have gone through that there are brake shoes or there is a block or there is a band or there is a leather. But in this case, instead of those things, we have a metallic disc. So the two flat pads are on the two sides of the disc. In the two flat pads which is given, that are on the two sides of the disc. The assembly in which the flat pads are held is the caliper assembly. In which the flat pads are held, this assembly is known as caliper assembly. In operation, that means how it operates. In operation, the pads are forced against the two sides of the disc. That means the pads which are given, these are the frictional pads. I have mentioned these also. So the frictional pads which are given on the both side of the brake disc is being allowed to move force against the two sides of the disc. So it is being forced against the brake disc, and hence by the movement of the piston in the caliper assembly. How it occurs? That means hydraulic fluid is being flown through this connecting tube. It ultimately pushes the piston inwards, and which ultimately apply force against the friction pad of through that brake disc. The pistons are actuated by hydraulic pressure fluid from master cylinder. I've already told you that the piston are being traveled by the hydraulic pressure being generated through this, which is being supplied by the master cylinder. This is how disc brake works. So if I conclude this in simple words, we can say that the master cylinder provides the hydraulic fluid through the connecting tube. It ultimately goes to the piston, which helps the piston to move inward, which ultimately presses the friction pads, and which ultimately provide a force against the brake disc, and which ultimately gives the braking force and applies the brakes on the wheel. So this is the overall conclusion of disc brake. I just go through this and write down all the mechanism part of disc brakes. And nonetheless, if you have any query, then let me know. I will clear you in next session. Okay. Thank you.